from standard 5. Today we are going to learn chapter 12, The Ant Explorer, part 2. Yesterday we have seen in the part 1 that CJ Dennis is explaining about an insect which is very tiny. It's a sugar ant which had taken the permission of mom and went all around to explore. It was feeling very tired, lonely, and he was not able to see all around because of the bushy grass, which was for him, it was like a dense forest, and also the stones which were 7 inch high, thinking that it's a like a mighty mountain. So the struggle we saw, and he has said that he will be not able to move anymore. He will not roam. He want to go back to the bed. So now we will see today the paragraph next. His little legs were wobbly. His strength was nearly spent. So he turned around again and peered the way he went. Back away from desert lands, feet and feet across. Back along the bridge of ferns bending in the moss. Through the fearful forest, grass shutting out the sky. So here says that his aunt's little legs were wobbly, shaking. No strength was there. All the strength was spent. And he was rounding, turning around, and he goes here and there. He wanted to go back from the desert. He came to the land, feet and feet across. He was walking again and again. And he came to the bridge of ferns, which is grasses are bending on the moss. And through the fearful forest, since the grass were high, it was really fearful for him. And he felt that the sky was shut because he could not see. He was under the grasses. Up a mighty mountain range, 7 inches high. Down a gloomy gully where he didn't like being alone. Up and down a small plant and round a stone. See, here is telling a mighty mountain range. The stone was looking like a very big mountain, and though it was 7 inches high only, and between the grass he found that is gloomy gully, means a very dark, narrow way where he did not like to be alone. It was a very fearful between the small plant and all around the stone. A dreary ant, a weary ant, decided no more to roam. He staggered up the garden path and poked right back home. He is telling that one very dreary and weary ant, which one he decided that not to roam anymore. He was so tired, struggling. So he staggered to walk. Staggered means shaking, like a drunkard walks like that, because his legs were having no more strength. And in the garden he moved to the land, and then he poked right back home like a flying the speed he took up to reach somehow to his home back. So children, this poem you have to remember, learn it by heart, and we will have once again recapitulation that little insect was tired of roaming all around. His desire was to explore everywhere. But now as he went out, he understood the difficulty, the adventurous journey, and he wanted to return home. He went through forest, he went to the mountains, and he came to the land, sandy area, and the also the bridge which is made with the ferns falling or bending on the moss. So thank you, children.